Hey there, I'm Chris from Klangio, and today I will show you how to create these play-along videos with guitar tabs. The idea for this video was suggested in the comments, so feel free to let me know what kind of tutorial you want to see next. And of course, subscribe to stay tuned. Now, let's get to it. We will need the following software, which is all free to download. For editing, we will use DaVinci Resolve or any other editing software you prefer. OBS to record the screen of your computer, TuxGuitar or Guitar Pro to display guitar tabs, and of course, a guitar profile. What was that? You don't have the guitar profile you need? No worries, because with Guitar to Tabs, you can turn your guitar playing into a guitar profile within just a couple seconds, using Klangio's AI magic, which also works for bass, pianos, drums and singing. Try it out for free right away by clicking the link in the description below. Now that I have my guitar profile, I will open up TuxGuitar, with which you can play back and edit guitar profiles. You can find the download link for the software in the description below. Click on File and then Open on the top left corner right here, and then browse for the guitar profile you want to use. Now we will crop the view of the tabs so that only about 4 bars are visible, which will make the editing process later a lot easier. For that, minimize the window and use the Control key and your mouse wheel to zoom into the view. You can also do that by clicking on View and then zoom in right here. Now I will also adjust the height by cropping the bottom of the window. When we play back the file now, the tabs will automatically display the next 4 bars once the previous bars are done playing. Now we're ready to do a screen recording of the tabs playback. For that, I will open up OBS, for which I've also put a download link in the description below. First, click on Settings, Output and Recording, and choose the path where your recording should be saved. Now under the Scene section, click on this plus and give it a name. Then under Sources, click on this plus too, select Display Capture and name it as well. Finally, make sure that under the Audio tab, the desktop audio slider is all the way up. And then click here to start recording. Now you can simply play back the song in TuxGuitar for as long as you want to play along to. And once you're done, click here to stop recording. Perfect, we're halfway there already. Next, we will also need a video of you playing. While filming yourself, make sure that everything that should be visible in the final video is contained in the bottom half of the recording, because we will need some space to display the tabs later. And when you're ready to record your playing, it's best to play along to the playback of TuxGuitar so that your playing is perfectly in time. Once you recorded a good take, transfer it to your computer. And now it's editing time, meaning we will put everything together in DaVinci Resolve. Again, a download link is in the description below. After installing, open it up and click on Untitled Project. First, let's save this project by pressing Ctrl S and naming it. Next up, click on the Edit tab here and drag and drop all the good recordings into this box. Now, first I will add the video of me playing by dragging it into the timeline here and then crop the video to the take that I want to use. I can do that by hovering over the edges here and dragging them along the timeline to shorten the video. Next, drag and drop the screen recording of your tabs into the timeline as well. Make sure to drag this video into a lane that's above the video of you playing. Now click somewhere on the timeline where the screen recording is positioned to view it up here. And then select the screen recording video so that it has a red frame. Open up the inspector in the top right corner here and use the cropping section to cut away all parts of the recording that doesn't contain the tabs. Then you can use the transform tools to zoom in and position the cropped video so that it's visible in the top or the bottom of this preview. While the screen recording is still selected, find the exact moment where the first note is played and then press the M key to set a marker. Then we will also search for that moment in the video of you playing, select the video again and press M. We can now drag the videos on top of each other and make sure that the markers are aligned. If needed, you can use the transform section again to position the videos so that everything is visible. When we play back the preview now, both videos should be perfectly in sync. Next, let's have a look at the audio section down here. You can increase and decrease the volume of each track by selecting them and using the volume slider here, which you can find in the audio tab in the inspector. That way, you can also mute the audio of the screen recording if you don't want it to be audible in the final video. And optionally, you can also add the audio of the original song by dragging the audio file into DaVinci and then adding it to a new audio lane, which I won't do due to copyright reasons. All that's left now is to make sure that both videos start and end at the same time, which we can do by cropping them on both ends, and finally moving them to the start of the timeline by selecting the empty space and hitting the delete key. Now we can click on render over here, type in a name for the video and select a location by clicking on browse. You can also change the video format to MP4 if you want that right over here. And finally click on add to render queue and then on render all. And we're done. Congrats, you made your own play along videos including tabs. Now all that's left is uploading it somewhere and sharing it with your friends. I hope this video helped you to get started, and as always, feel free to ask anything in the comments and leave a like and subscribe to stay tuned. I'll be back, baby.